This video is part of a larger adventure that explores the Great Western Trail in sections, including some alternate routes.
Waking life, your profile in shadow. Raise yourself to the morning glow. Night is gone, long way turning. You've waited long enough to know.
Today is July 19th, 2021. And I'm out on the Great Western Trail with Kristiana this time. Yeah, stoked to be picking up the trail where I left off last year on a long day trip going south from the right-hand fork near Logan. For this trip, yeah, we're doing it as a backpack. It's gonna total something like 23 miles with maybe 12 or 13 miles today and 10 or 11 miles tomorrow. The second half, as we go northbound, is gonna be mostly waterless. So we're definitely planning for that. And yeah, gonna enjoy a fun, 36-hour adventure, something like that or less. And we'll see how we go here on the Great Western Trail near Logan Canyon. Just came across a rather large rattlesnake there. You can see with the stripes. Yeah, that must have been what, like 3 feet long?
I just heard it, I didn't see it.
Fortunately, it was slithering away from us. So not an aggressive snake, but just a couple feet off of the trail. Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen a rattlesnake on the trail, so that was kind of exciting. And now it's moving away a little further.
Yeah, I'm glad it's moving away. That makes me feel better.
Yeah, me too.
It's definitely moving away.
Rest your eyes in waking light.
Today is July 21st, 2021. And we made it almost 12 miles up the Great Western Trail, passing Temple Fork and Spawn Creek, and a rather warm worm fence trail. And we're very pleased to see that Worm Fence Spring was flowing, so we definitely tanked up on water there enough to get us all the way back to the car today, which is another 9 miles and change thereabouts along the Turkey Trail and others. We were expecting it to be dry for this second half of the trip going north, but with the very steady rain that came last night, we might be seeing some puddles and who knows, maybe some little creeks that are flowing or something. But yeah, it was a nice refresh with the rain after a very hot hike yesterday. With that, we will see how we go on day number two of this Great Western Trail segment near Logan Canyon. Just made it back to my car here at the end of Right Hand Fork at the trailhead where we started the Willow Hollow Trail yesterday morning. So special thanks to Kristiana for staging her car at what is the northern terminus of the Logan section of the Great Western Trail here in Utah. In any case, yeah, the trail actually, it just seemed to keep getting better and better as we got north. To be honest, I was a little discouraged on the first half of yesterday, the first day, with all the grazing that it, you can tell it kind of taken a toll on the landscape there, at least for someone like me who's into the recreation and the scenic beauty of it. But yeah, it definitely got better as we got north. Worm Fence Road is really where the scenery started, for me, getting to be exceptional, even if it was blazingly hot. We definitely got uncomfortable and we're struggling with that heat until we got up and over, and we're pleasantly surprised by the fact that Worm Fence Springs was flowing ice cold. So that really sort of made the second half of the trip for us and provided water in a way that didn't require us to go off trail down towards Logan River to source water. On the last like 10 mile chunk or so, which was without water for the most part, save for a little very slow couple of springs in the last like few miles. The scenery was extraordinary through the Stump Hollow area and also getting up to Stump Hollow. Yeah, we had a great time, found a great campsite that was there not too far from where Little Bear Creek enters into the Great Western Trail. In total, we ended up doing a little over 21 miles in not even 36 hours. It was more like 32 hours or so. We're on our way to Logan to hopefully score some ice cream and maybe some other treats. But that was another section of the Great Western Trail here in Utah. And with that, I'll say so long for now. And see you next time.